वेलकम एवरीवन टू द कॉन्शियसनेस फिजिक्स लेक्चर सीरीज। दिस इज मैथमेटिकल फिजिक्स लेक्चर 5। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम फ्रॉम सिलिंड्रिकल टू कार्टेशियन एंड वाइस वर्सा। सो इन अ जेनरिक फॉर्म यू नो दैट अ वेक्टर ए कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन कार्टेशियन एज ए एक्स टाइम्स एक्स कैप प्लस ए वाई टाइम्स वाई कैप प्लस ए इज अ टाइम जेड कैप, राइट। एंड इन सिलिंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ आर थीटा एंड फाइ, व्हिच इज ए आर इन द आर कैप प्लस ए फाइ इन द फाइ कैप डायरेक्शन प्लस ए जेड इन द जी कैप डायरेक्शन। नाउ व्हाट आई कैन डू इज दैट वी कैन टेक द डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ एज अ सिलिंड्रिकल सिस्टम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू r cap, right? So a cylindrical dot r cap is equal to ar times r cap dotted into r cap plus what a phi times phi cap dotted into phi cap, phi cap dotted into r cap plus a z times z cap dotted into r cap. So basically that's what you can do. Now you can see that r cap dotted into r cap must be equal to 1 and phi cap dotted into r cap must be equal to 0 and z cap dotted into phi cap is equal to 0 because they are the 90 degrees axis. So a cylinder dotted into r cap is equal to ar. Similarly, a dotted into phi cap must be equal to a phi and a dotted into z cap must be equal to a z, which is very apparent from this equation right there. Now what I'm going to do next is that you can write the generic form of ar must be equal to ax in the x times x dot r cap plus ay times y dot r cap plus az times z dot r cap. And similarly, a phi in the generic form must be equal to ax times x dot phi cap plus ay times y dot phi cap plus az times z dot phi cap. And also a z must be equal to ax times x dot z cap plus ay times y dot z cap plus az times z dot what z dot z cap. So this is the basic transformation of a vector from r cap to z cap. We don't know the values of x dot z, all these things we don't know the values of that, so we need to find out what the values are. Now let's compute what the actual dot products of these coordinate axes are. We have x, y and z in the Cartesian, which is written on the columns, and we have, this is a dot product triangle table, and we have r, phi and z in the x axis and x, phi and z in the y axis to compute. Let's see what the dot products are. So for that we have to consider our coordinate system x, y, z and the right-handed coordinate system in the Cartesian system, and our vector r, which is our vector, testing vector. So we have our coordinate system. These coordinate systems are perpendicular to each other, and we can write down what the dot product, a typical dot product a dot b must be equal to ab cos theta. We are here looking at the unit vector, so the magnitude of these things are just one, so it is, the only thing is cos theta. So cos theta is the only component we need to find out. So we can see that z is just perpendicular to other axes and it is zero to z axis. Z dot z is just cos 0, which is 1. And in the, now we have to look at what the x and y dependence of r, right? So vector r cap. So r cap is in the outwards direction and it is a phi angle from the x axis, right? So, and the other angle will be 90 minus phi then. The total angle will be 90, so the other angle will be 90 minus phi. So we can write down x dot r must be equal to cos phi. Cos phi, just like that, because it's a phi dependence. Now let's look at x dot y dot phi. Y dot phi will be what, 90 minus phi. So typical sine function is like this and typical cos function looks like that. So we have to look at the cos function, and we have to look at cos 90 minus phi, right? We have to shift our angle at 90 degrees, right? 90 degrees, which is pi by 2. If we shift a cos function to pi by 2 side backwards, you can see that if you shift it pi by 2, then it will become a sine function, and right? Just like that. So it will be a sine function. So cos 90 minus phi is just sine phi, right? Sine phi. Now let's look at what we have with the phi cap direction, x dot phi. So what will be x dot phi? So for finding that, we have to look at the x cap direction, x and phi direction. So phi is just perpendicular to r cap, right? So phi is just perpendicular to r cap, so it is phi angle phi plus a 90 degrees, right? Perpendicular 90 degrees will be added to this thing, so it is just cos phi plus 90 degrees, right? So cos phi plus 90 degrees, if you shift the angle to a plus 90 degrees, what will happen? So if you shift it to a 90 degrees, it will become an inverse sine function, right? So a negative sine function if you shift that, so it will be a minus sine phi, right? Minus sine phi. Now you have to look at y dot phi. So y is 90 minus phi, just like that, and phi is perpendicular to r cap, right? So y is 90 minus phi to the r cap and plus the 90 degrees to the phi cap. So this shift will give you a 180 minus phi, right? 180 minus phi, cos 180 minus phi, so it is cos pi minus phi. So if you shift the cos function with a phi dependence, so if you shift it one more to a phi difference, then it will be another cos phi, right? So it will be the same but shifted into cos phi, so it will be a cos phi. So that's that, and now we have to look at z cap. So z cap is perpendicular to r cap and phi cap, so it is just 90 degrees. So cos 90 is 0, so that will be the dot product table for our computation. So that's the dot product table. So what we have done is that we have found a way to transform our vector from Cartesian to cylindrical by using, we are multiplying ax, ay, z with the transformation matrix cos phi minus sin phi 0, cosine phi, cos phi 0, 0, 0, 1. This is the transformational matrix. We multiply it with the Cartesian system and you get ax cos phi plus ay sin phi plus 0 ax minus ax sin phi plus ay cos phi plus 0, and we get az. So this is the transformational vector and this is transformed into ar, a phi and az. So this is the transformed into cylindrical coordinate system. This vector is transformed right into cylindrical coordinate system. So this is how you transform a vector. Okay, now let's do an example problem. A basic form of A is equal to AX, X cap plus AY, Y cap plus AZ, A cap. Now a given vector A times A is equal to X, X cap plus Y, Y cap plus Z, Z cap. And we need to transform this vector into cylindrical coordinate system. We know the basic transformation X equal to R cos phi and Y is equal to R sin phi and Z is equal to Z for cylindrical coordinate system. Now what we can do is that we can now transform this vector using this A is equal to R cos phi, X cap plus R sin phi, Y cap plus Z into Z cap. So this is the vector here need to be transformed. Let's find out the component AR. AR is equal to AX cos phi plus AX sin phi. So it's R, this is AX, this is AY and this is AZ, right? So AR must be equal to what? AR must be equal to R cos phi in the R cos phi times cos phi, right? Plus R sin phi times sin phi in the Y cap direction. So that is R cos square phi plus sin square phi, that is equal to R. So A phi is the next thing, which is minus ax sin phi plus ay cos phi. So that will be equal to minus r cos phi sin phi plus r what r sin phi cos phi sin phi cos phi, which will be sin phi cos phi, which will be cancelled each other. So it is just r times 0, so that is just 0. Az is just z, so that must be equal to what? Z. So vector A in the cylindrical coordinate system will look like what? In the cylindrical coordinate system, it is R, R cap plus Z, Z cap. So that's the vector transformed from X, Y, Z into a cylindrical coordinate system. Now let's return the vector back into Cartesian coordinate system. That's R, R cap plus Z, Z cap into Cartesian. So AX is going to be AX, A dot X, right? Vector A dot X will be AX. So we have to multiply, we have to take the dot product with X. So we get R R cap dotted into X cap plus Z times Z cap dotted into X cap, right? This will be the transformation. So it is R cos phi plus 0 and that will be the X component AX right? Ax component. Now the y component ay will be a dot y, so that will be r cap dotted into y cap plus z times z cap dotted into y cap. So that will be equal to r sine phi plus 0, right? R sine phi plus 0, so that's the y component ay, right? Similarly, az will be a dot z, right? Vector a dot z, that will be r times what? R dot z, right? R dot z plus z times z dot z, right? So that will be 1. Z dot z is equal to 1, other things are 0. So a transformed vector, a is equal to r cos phi in the x cap direction plus r sin phi in the y cap direction plus z cap, right? So that is just x cap plus y cap plus z cap. So that's how you transform your vector from Cartesian to cylindrical and from cylindrical to Cartesian coordinate system back and forth easily. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you for your support. Please like, share and subscribe and comment whatever things that you get in your mind. And for more videos, you get to Consciousness Physics. Thank you.